I'm at the Zook station at Illuminarium, and my ride has arrived, and I have opened the door, and now I'm going to just make a little video of this vehicle from all around, and then I'm going to get in. So I'm about to get in here, and we'll do this in daylight hours as we did in nighttime. Now, all you do is you get in, and see, there's seats on both sides. So I'm going to sit on the other side. Now you use this to touch the closed door. So we're going to close the door, and then it won't let me start the vehicle until I fasten my seatbelt. So I'm going to fasten my seatbelt right here. Now that we fasten seatbelt, it's going to allow me to start the ride. Alrighty, we have started the ride, and we are on our way.
If you need help, you can use the help menu on the touchscreen.
See, that's the Zoox station. Another car is pulled up behind us, another pod, and there goes the Zoox station at the Illuminarium. And if you haven't been to the Illuminarium, I would highly recommend it. It is fascinating. I did the two rides. There's the wind back there. I did the space and the other, I don't know what it was called, but it was amazing. It did the whole story of Earth from single cell creatures to jellyfish. Things go all around you, and then fish, and then to dinosaurs, and then you go down to, and then the asteroid hits and the dinosaurs are gone, and then humans, all the animals appear, and then they build cities and spaceships and go into space, and it was amazing. See up there, now that is the LiDAR. I think there's two of them. There's one on each side, but we'll look at it more carefully when we get out. Still says 12 minutes. Time hasn't changed. And you can change the music. If you don't like the music, you can change it. Hey, this car, the last car, the one that brought me here, this window had kind of dirty. It had rain and dust spots, but this one is perfectly clean. Must have just came out of the garage. Look at that. Now we have stopped. This time I'm looking at it from the back side, but we have stopped because of the traffic light, I presume. We're down to 11 minutes and counting. These guys are behind us. There's a little net over here so that we don't go behind. So last time they told us it was 19. We got 19 of these running around, but there might be more today because it seems they've added more spots to the destination. Day one, there were just 5 spots. Now it seems like there's a few more. I think one of the spots they added is Illuminarium and Area 15. But Area 15 and Illuminarium are both the same thing. So they just have more ways for people. Some people may not know Area 15 is Illuminarium. They want to get there. So we're trying to make it easier for them. And I didn't know about Illuminarium. I wasn't planning to come here. The only reason I came here and stayed for the shows is because of Zoox. So the Illuminarium has Zoox to thank for me visiting them and buying their ticket and buying from their gift shop. I bought a shirt that says billions and billions of colors, which is really cute. Alrighty, signal turned green and now we're turning. I don't know what it'll do if I open my seatbelt. I'm not gonna do it. I don't want to mess with it. But I think I made a mistake. I shouldn't have chosen to sit on this side. The last time I sat on the other side, so I thought I see everything as it passes by rather than being able to see things as we approach them. But I think I can turn my camera here and you might be able to see what's coming up rather than what's just gone by. I love this roof. And this car is amazing. These seats, you sit opposite each other. So if you have a big party, a family, you can talk to each other while riding. You don't sit like in regular cars in two seats. You're not able to face one another and talk properly. This would be a definite improvement. And most people, they just use their cars 1 to 5% of the time. The rest of the time is just sitting in their driveway doing absolutely nothing for anybody. So if you don't own a car and just use pods like this in the city to go wherever you need to go, you can increase the usefulness of vehicles by 20 times, hundreds of times. So if you can increase the asset utilization of vehicles from a few percent to 20%, 25%, 30%, 40%, you can have an enormous benefit to society. One of the locations is the sports world. So the benefits to society are in the trillions and trillions of dollars. If all your goods and services in the city are moving on pods like this, and you don't have to clean them, you don't have to service them, you don't have to register them, you don't have to insure them, you don't have to do anything. Look at the amount of time you will save. And if you live in a home and you have a garage, you can reclaim that garage and turn it into a room, have more space. And if you live, even if you go to a store and they have free parking, it's not free parking. The price of the parking is included in the price of the goods and services you're buying wherever you go and park. And parking is not cheap. Parking is extremely expensive. So if we don't have to build parking lots, that'll be an enormous saving to society. We could save trillions of dollars for transportation of goods and services through cities. It'll be a different, cleaner world. Less congestion, less vehicles, more green space, more healthy environment. It will be awesome. You won't have these paved miles of parking lots. They'll all be gone. We don't need any parking lots. We won't need, if everybody switched to these driverless pods. 8 minutes left. I would love to see that day when, hey, there's another pod behind us. See that? Can you see that pod right behind us? It's right behind us. Wouldn't it be nice if all the vehicles on the road were just these pods? And we didn't have any parking lots. That would be amazing. Awesome. That would be fantastic. Hey, nobody's driving that little pod. I wish I had a telescoping my gimbal. I didn't bring it. If I had it, I could have taken a better picture of that pod behind us. You can see the lighter on top and the other sensors and cameras on the sides of the vehicle. Right. Signal must have opened. So we're going. We have a green light where that pod goes. I think it went straight. It's not following us. Different location. If you're visiting Las Vegas, I would highly recommend that you get on one of these pods. Amazon Zoox pod. All you have to do is download the Zoox app on your phone and just sign in with your email. And if you have an Amazon account, then it's even easier. I think you just give them the email of your Amazon account and it's seamless. And you can start enjoying Zoox rides. And all you do is you go to the app and you say where you want to go. A menu appears of all the locations they're serving right now. You choose your destination and it says locating your vehicle. And as soon as it locates your vehicle, hey, there's another one going on the other side. It will, and another one, two of them going on the other side. So it tells you how many minutes your ride will arrive in. And then it tells you how long it will take for the trip and the number of the vehicle. And then when it arrives, you keep monitoring, and when you have a minute or two left, you go out to the designated pickup spot. And then when it comes, you just have to press a button on your app to open the door. It will unlock the doors. You get in, you fast close the door, then you fasten your seatbelt. Then you can press a green button to start at the ride. And that's all there is to it. Pretty easy, seamless. We're going by another casino. Oh, look at these cool buildings. Nice building. Looking buildings. This time we get to see them from the other side. I hope in the future they can make these pods with even more glass and less of a body. But these pods use less space on the road, so you can fit more pods in the same amount of road. So you don't need as many roads. So you can save money on your roads and parking for both passenger and merchandise. That would be an amazing world. 2 minutes have left. We're stopped at another traffic light. We're about to reach our destination. We're at the T-Mobile Arena and we're on the go again. Everywhere in Las Vegas, they have cool art on the sides of the road. Here, we're passing by Excalibur, approaching the Luxor Hotel. The Luxor has the Blue Man Group. If you haven't seen the Blue Man Group, I would highly recommend you go and see them. They're amazing. There's Luxor. Also, the Rio has Penn and Teller. It's another good show that I've seen. And there's the Excalibur. and King Arthur. We're almost there, says 1 minute. Pretty soon it's gonna tell me to gather my belongings. This is the way to travel, man.
We're arriving soon. Please collect your phone and other items.
It gives you a little reminder. All your stuff, and there's another pot. And we are almost over right besides the, this is Egyptian stone and carvings, you see? Hieroglyphics. We're at Luxor. Going up into Luxor now. I have to remember to take my gift back. See? Oops. Okay. It says finding the best place to stop. This looks like a pretty good spot. Okay.
We've arrived.
Okay, it opens as I touch the switch. Okay, I have to, there, I unbuckled myself. And now I'm gonna pick up my, hey, the clearance is not that high. I almost bumped my head to the top. Okay, I'm Zoox, and the door is closed, and the car is off to pick up its next passenger. That was an amazing ride. Thank you for riding with me in Las Vegas for the debut of the future of urban transportation, the Zoox pods. These pods should be the only vehicles on the road, hopefully soon. For Clean Titans, this is Ali signing off. Please like, share, subscribe, and questions about, and stay tuned for more cool content from Clean Titans.